How do we overcome circumstances and become greater than situations, thus become bigger, better, and greater than we have ever been? Something that our environment has so ill prepared us, something that we are not ready for, that we have not been taught. In days of old, it was necessary that the young go to their elders for knowledge and wisdom. But in the times that we are confronted with, in nearly all cases, if we were to do so, we would not be any better off, being that our elders, they themselves have failed to learn anything from their elders, and thus, that is not of use. So basically, our miseducational system treats individuals as if they were a collective mechanism, in which if you teach them, or not teach them, but if you well oil them, that they will benefit in assembly line and run smooth for the rest of eternity. Failing to comprehend that each individual comes from a different background, experience, circumstances, situations, acquaintances, teachings, learnings, environments, and so each individual must overcome their own circumstance and situation and confrontation. Education requires I to teach individuals to be bigger and better than circumstances they face, that they are stronger, and that we must teach them that they are well equipped to reason and learn the way to become overcome and be triumphant, victorious, passing over, overcoming the difficulties which they are confronted with. Now, in order that this may function appropriately, men, women, and children must be taught to seek the proper and correct and accurate interpretation of the difficulties from which they have been confronted with. They must be able to comprehend that any confrontation, difficulty, or circumstance, situation contains no wrong whatsoever, no evil, no negativity, and we must be able to learn and comprehend and accept that it very well may have been and very well is the only and the most beautiful and the bestest thing, the bestest of whatever it is that it is that could have ever happened. We must do away with the knowledge of good and evil, and we must accept all for the good that it can, for the good that it can be, for the good that it is, and the good that it will be, and was. We must be able to accept this, and when humanity can receive this, then surely humanity can move on ahead into bigger, better things. When we are manifested upon this earth, we are ignorant of all difficulty until that moment that we are awakened, in which we are discomforted by the many discomforts of this seemingly evil world. But in reality, it's a world of opportunities in which the more you suffer, the more you can learn. And all sufferings are requirements that we may grow. A realization that there is more that we must achieve and attain in order to live a life in where we overcome discomforts. And these discomforts are only but an opportunity that are presented to us to mature and reach a higher level of comprehending, understanding, overstanding, and thus a higher level of being an elevation of perfection that eventually will enable us to go on ahead, pass over to a higher height, that which is no longer suitable to be attained in this experience, in this world, we could say, in this reality. But first we must slowly use all stumbling blocks as stepping stones, that we may attain this eternal perfection of growth. And we must know and understand that we are not confronted with anything that we cannot overcome, for that is not within the boundaries of natural or nature or being or existence. Nature itself, the laws of physics and the laws of creation would not allow that to be so, and so we must know and teach everyone to accept and comprehend that there is a solution, and that there is very well the capability within each and every one of us to overcome whatever difficulty we are confronted with. And by knowing this, then surely we can realize that, okay, we could just stop instead of panicking and getting all out of control or putting ourselves in a state of denial. Then we could be like, okay, so teacher said, our Rebbe said, our master said, that nothing we're confronted with is impossible to overcome, because we're confronted with only that which we are capable of overcoming, and so there must be a solution. And thus the individual is capable of reasoning and logically finding out that answer to how to go about in the most dignified sense and achieve a triumph and a victory and go on ahead to another difficulty, that they may grow. If we could teach individuals within this human experience to know that, then there would be nothing but progress. For ones would know that, okay, now it's time for me to become bigger and better, and thus this opportunity to figure out how to go about it in a moral and dignified way, and grow, and take on other difficulties that'll lead to the everlasting perfection of the existence of truth, what we are. So it is necessary to train the youth to know this, so that every potential, every opportunity to grow will only be received as such, without any difficulties, knowing that this is the best that could ever happen to them, because it is necessary. It's been placed before them, because it is the best situation for them to grow. They need that. We need that. And we must be able to interpret how to go about it in a dignified and a good morale, with a good morale, and thus go on ahead to everlasting growth and progress. So, and we must know that nothing is evil. Taking on these attitudes and applying these attitudes and bringing forth that change in attitude that is required of us all will bring about this kingdom of heaven. But we must do away with wrong, evil, and good and evil, for all is good. All comes from a good creator. It's like an imaginary world where everyone that is not of truth, I mean, they're just a sacrifice. They're only like a technological, a scenery, in where the ones that are children to the Most High, children of the creation, the sons of the creator, in which we can go past these simulations and learn and grow and become better. Our Father would not put us in a real situation that we could actually face annihilation or destruction or harm. So this is take it as like a video game, we could say. You're not really in harm's way, because there is no way you could actually die within the video game. In a sense, that's kind of like what the word is, what this matrix is. And so we must learn to navigate ourselves through this learning experience, through this training, and know that all is for good, for our good, and that if we were not well cared for, then we would not be chastised. There's actually something we got in mind, but our English does not allow us to be able to express it all that well clearly. But it is like we said it once before. Give we a few seconds to actually try to come to that, like a virtual reality, a simulation of a make pretend scenery in which one trains to become a police officer or something like that. I mean, this is really what it is. But it's not to, you know, please do not confuse this and misinterpret this and bring forth a wrong interpretation and pretending that one can jump off a building and live. For we must obey the commandments, because those commandments will enable us to maneuver ourselves through this simulated experience without the default of death, of real death, you know. We didn't want to go into this, but it is, in a sense, maintaining the integrity that as long as we keep the commandments of what is, and what is only truth, and what is truth is is that which is, we have to accept that it is that which has been instructed to us, the instructions that we have been given that are found in the Bible, that is truth. And we don't, it tells us things in a way that we don't have to be able to see them, but we just have to take it as that's what it is. For if we keep those commandments, then we are maintained in this virtual reality in which we are not capable or not susceptible or vulnerable to real pains and real death, is what we're trying to say. So if we stick to the rules, then this will continue being an illusion. If you break the rules, you become vulnerable and you become attached to this reality, and thus it becomes true, and you die along with this, with you die truly, because nature cannot break its own rules. And if you break the rules, then you are not of truth, and you are a threat to truth, and you must be done away with. But as long as we maintain our integrity, then we will keep on this well protected and well safe opportunity, world of opportunities that should only be used to overcome and thus reach a higher perfection, and in an everlasting perfection, the game is never over. So don't expect that life is something in which you overcame a difficulty and it's all just relaxing and chilling and comfort living for since then on. Not thus, not so. It is, the race is not for the swift, but for the sure, for those that endure to the very last, and thus, you know, accept, introduce the very beginning. So with that, you know, excuse me, we didn't want to bring in the whole integrity, but being that we did, we hope to kind of go into that in a future presentation. So until then, Shalom Rastafari.